Dear students, welcome to the video lecture series on food and cosmetic analysis. In this ninth video, you are going to learn about analysis of reducing sugar in honey by Colles ferricide method or Lane-Enon method. So in this video, by using two methods, we are going to see how we can do the analysis of reducing sugar present in honey. So here is the detailed procedure. Analysis of reducing sugar in honey. By Colles ferricide method, first we are going to see how to analyze the reducing sugar present in the honey. This method involves redox titration for estimation of sugar in honey. The analysis is performed in two steps. First step is a standardization of ferricyanide solution. So how to do it? A appropriate volume of 1% potassium ferricyanide solution is taken in evaporating dish and titrated under boiling condition against standard lactose solution by using methylene blue as an indicator. Then next step is the estimation of reducing sugar. So first, take a definite quantity of diluted sample solution of honey. Titrate this sample solution against standardized potassium ferricyanide solution under boiling condition by using methylene blue as an indicator. The dispersion of color of indicator determine the end point. By recording the burette reading and applying conversion factor, we can determine the sugar content of the sample. So basically, by using this redox titration, we can determine the amount of sugar present in the honey. Then analysis of reducing sugar in honey is also done by using another method known as a Lane-Enon method. So this method is the same as we studied for the analysis of sugar in a milk sample. So we are also going to see this method for estimation or analysis of sugar in honey sample. So this is based on a determination of volume of a test solution required to reduce completely a known volume of alkaline copper reagent. The end point is indicated by use of an internal indicator methylene blue. This dye is reduced to methylene white by a slight excess of reducing agent, reducing sugar over that necessary to reduce all the copper. So here we'll see the detailed procedure. However, the methylene white is rapidly oxidized back to methylene blue due to presence of air. Hence, it is necessary to exclude the air from the sample. So this is accomplished by performing the titration while the solution being analyzed in boiling condition. So to remove the air from the sample solution, it is necessary to do the titration under boiling solution so that the air will be removed from the solution and that air will not undergo oxidation process. So here is the detailed procedure about how to analyze the sugar present in the honey. First, take a sample of honey and treat it with copper sulfate solution and sodium hydroxide. The NaOH added should be sufficient to precipitate completely the copper as a hydroxide. The solution is filtered and the filtrate is transferred in a burette. Here the mixed filling reagent is taken in a conical flask and is placed on a wire gauze and it is heated to boiling. It is rapidly titrated against the sugar solution filled in burette till the dye gets reduced. So this whole procedure can be shown in a form of picture in a next slide. So here the steps are again showing. Take a diluted sample of honey. Here by mistakenly milk is written, so please consider it as a honey. Diluted sample of honey is treated with copper sulfate pentahydrate solution and sodium hydroxide to precipitate completely the copper as a hydroxide. So here we can see the procedure. So this is the sample of a honey. This sample of honey in which NaOH is added and copper sulfate is added, and this copper sulfate is precipitated as a copper hydroxide. The solution is filtered and filtrate is transferred into the burette. So here is the next step. Whatever the copper hydroxide precipitated is a filter to remove the residue and to collect the filtrate. This filtrate we have to transfer into burette and then we have to use it for next step. So in the next step, the filtrate is transferred into a burette, rapidly titrated against mixed failing reagent till the dye get reduced. So here we can see the filtrate is transferred into the burette and then it is titrated rapidly with a boiled mixed failing reagent. Okay, so here it is shown how to prepare the mixed failing reagent. First prepare failing A, then prepare failing B and mix it together and boiled it and use for the titration. So it is shown that 7 gram of copper sulfate pentahydrate dissolved in distilled water containing 2 drops of dilute sulfuric acid. So this we have to take a 15 ml. Then a filling B solution in which 35 gram of potassium tartrate and 12 gram of NaOH in 100 ml of distilled water. So this will give the filling B solution. So we have to mix this filling A solution and filling B solution. We have to boil it and then we have to use for the titration. So this solution we have to titrate with the filtrate. From the burette reading, we are able to get the analysis of the reducing sugar present in the honey. So dear students, in this video you have learned about the analysis of reducing sugar in honey by two different methods. First was the Colles ferricyanide method and second was the Lane-Enon method. So please learn next topic of this unit in my next video. So till then, thank you very much for watching this video and I wish you a very happy e-learning.